concentrate on this portion of code. Only concentrate this portion. I've defined a function val x, and x I initialize it 15, print x id of x, and then again initialize x 10, print x id and val x and this x. See, in Python, probably wherever you know, in C, between parameter value can go by call by value and or call by reference. Whenever you see in your data structure class, if you see the parameters with some star or ampersand, you can guess it may be call by reference. There are some very advantages of call by reference. It is faster, quicker, and whatever. And call by value, it is a generally copied. A copied version is goes, and if anything changes in the copied version, it cannot come back. It yet come back by return something. So it is call by value. Mainly Python, they have gone for call by value, but call by reference is also there. I will try to show you this PPT screen. I hope I try to impress upon you this screen. I am not making a view mode, then it is very difficult to come back. You see it here, this is the same function, and here it is a basically I x is equal to t in a particular id number. You know, this is id of a, in this particular id, it depends on, maybe it's a 32-bit. For your case, it is a 64-bit, it's a huge number, but it is internal number, no issue. But what I want to impress upon you, for x is equal to t, if I any other variable I initialize with 10, they would have the same value. Okay, this actually Python indirectly keep it in another place and puts a pointer, but pointer is not available. Python keeping it. So this is it is basically a call by value. It is a basically call by value, and we call it immutable data types. Probably you know, then whenever C is being developed, there the memory is available, maybe 64 kilobyte is enough memory, right? Not like now, like 8 GB, 16 GB. That time memory has to be reused and reused again. So at that time, call by reference is the best choice, not by call by value. But now later on, when Python come up, Java came up later, they come to know that we have enough memory right now. It's 1990-91, so it will give a immutable data type that you have already known in dictionary, that immutable data type should be there in the key values. And one thing I must tell you, that in dictionary can contains a dictionary. That is a great thing. And that content, then you have to check at which level it detects. But a dictionary can contain a dictionary, and dictionary item key values should be always immutable one. And this immutable data concept is not there in C. It is totally concept comes from Python, to the best of my knowledge, because Java came up later. So Python is that a revolutionary in practice and immutable data type. But Python has a mutable data type also. Here you find it a list, a value list. I initialize with a list. How to do by list? I do not know by this. I don't know. I come to know, or we come to know, that this third bracket opening, and third bracket means it's a list. If it is a second bracket, it's a set or dictionary. If it is a second bracket with some pairs, that is a dictionary. Without pairs, is a set. Okay, and so here, see here the program, the function, I declare it here, and here we first initialize a list with 1, 2, 3, and then I print the list and the ID of this. Then I call val, this is the definition of val. Then I append 4 to it and print ID, and in same case you see the ID would not change, unlike here. Okay, this is a call, you can call it a call by reference, not by call by value. So it is called by assignment also. See, it is a mutable data type. So list is a mutable data type. It is called by reference. So whenever in your program you want to put a large chunk of data, to want to make it faster, to transfer to a function, so it is better to do it by list, because it will be definitely faster, because list is a mutable data type. It not changing. So Python keeps the same place. So it depends application. But here we have the same thing, is an integer. You know, any data type in Python is an immutable data type, unlike C. So here, whenever x is equal to 15, Python particular location selected, put it there. So actually program starts here, it is a function, and always you know the function calls a def and colon should be there, and I prefer 2 characters but they prefer the 4 characters. So it is your choice, and there will be always a single line should be there. It is recommended. So you know this is a different portion. Actually program starts here. So x is equal to 10, this is x is equal to 10 and val of x. Then x is equal to 10, this is the area, then I call this function, then within the function I change it. So Python keeps another place, unlike here. In list they put it the same place, and whenever I change it to integer, the Python put it another place. So that is the thing. Call by value and call by reference in Python is available. Call by value, you can call it, this is a call by value. And this is a list, is a call by reference. So we can show it, try to show it in the code. Hopefully I can show. This is, now see that this same code is running. We can see it here. So here, x is equal to 15, whenever, the first is code starts here. Remember, this is a function. The function code runs here. X is equal to 10, the value, and this is the pointer. Not a pointer, it's an ID number. There is no use you can do it. This ID, then I call I print it, then I val x, then I call the function and x15 plus x ID x. So you see, whenever I make it change 15, then it is changing. Value changes. Okay, value changes. Then again, I ask the print x, then again it comes to the 10 and this is the value. Whenever outside the function, because you know this is internal variable x, because within a function, so whenever I come to, this is not a global, I haven't declared it global, so whenever we come out, whenever it's a print x, the same this value is printed, and so this is a immutable data type, ordinary data type immutable. Now we go for a list data type. How this is the program begins here. Okay, and this is the function. Okay, so program begins here. I initialize the list, third bracket opening 1, 2, 3, and then I print the list, ID of list, and I call val, and val within a val, I append a 4 to it and print ID. We found it the same call by reference. See, we ID doesn't change. So list is a, you can say it's a, you can make it a call by reference. Sometimes it is beneficial. So Python has all the pros and cons of C. Like if you go for a Java, that is only object-oriented programming. But in Python, you can do like C, procedural programming. What is procedural programming? Procedural, you think yourself have you are yourself a particular CPU, and you work by yourself. And you run by functions and all. And what is object-oriented programming? You think I have a multiple CPU. I can run the program at various places. They can exchange messages and all these things. That is the basics of object-oriented programming. So procedural programming concerns a particular CPU, a very fast CPU, and they can do. So, but both has pros and cons. Sometimes the procedural programming is much faster result for numerical computations, say seismic data or any numerical computation, procedural programming is better. So Python has both, but Java unfortunately have all object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming means you have to call again multiple type of function calls and lots of reference, and time may be required. But Python, though it is slower than Java because it's interpreted and it's a dynamic type. I have to data type again and again, like Python is a strong type data but dynamic. C is strong type, static, not dynamic. everything before running your program at the programming level, you have to declare which kind of data is integer or float or character. Unfortunately, string is not there at the C. But these are all mutable data type. But what's the advantage of Python? They have created another data set that is all standard data, like character, integer. They make it as immutable so that they run faster, because we have enough amount of memory is there, string data type is there, but they have keep a provision some mutable data type. That is, example is your list. List is a mutable data type. The mutable data type can be there in the dictionary at the value position, not at the key position. Key position will be always a immutable data type. But here, this small program, I wish to show you that this is the first program. It is an immutable data type, very integer, and you see the internal reference point change, and here you see if you pass to list, so that is it. Now, pandas. Pandas is basically for handling huge amount of data. You already know Python has a disadvantage that it doesn't have an array. I find it array should be there. Why it is not? But it is a particularly one-man decision. He designed the language in that way in 1989. He thought it that instead of array, he put it list. But list has a lot of advantages and disadvantages. What are the disadvantages of list is you can have put a different data type, but list is also an index. But remember, your dictionary cannot have index like 0, 1, like this. Dictionary can only be indexed only by, not by 0, 1. It has it by key value you can search. I'm mixing this so that I'm repeating this kind of statement so that you can correlate and you can ask from the question from basic thing anywhere else. So why we are going for pandas? Pandas, whatever I believe what is the design criteria of Python is, the basic Python, they want to make it a very simple one. So that is the thing they put it least, but least disadvantage is because the different data types are there, maybe character, string, integer, floating point. So you say if there are 100 items in the list, you don't know which element takes how many bytes are, how many bytes, 2 bytes, 4 bytes, 7, 6, 7 bytes. So you have to always go from very beginning. And so that is, you cannot guess correctly. Which, if you want to say, I want the 100th element of the list, so you have to cross 99 and you cannot multiply because you don't know which kind of data type is there. That is, I found the disadvantage of list. But array concept, which is not there in basic Python, you have to always import NumPy as np or import NumPy. They are the not only array, it is much more powerful function of array. You know, within NumPy you can calculate maximum, minimum, all better functions are there, and you can, but what is the negative point of NumPy is it is but the least is you cannot put different data type. Okay, NumPy is a same data type, or it is a 4-byte integer or 8-byte or 10-byte, you have to all similar type of huge arrays, multi-dimensional array. But the pandas is you can put a different data types. You can put a whole Excel table into it. It is mostly relatable to Excel table. I'll come to this. Excel table, you know, lots of data you can put. Rows can be duplicated, unlike your RDBMS. Probably you have some concept of somebody RDBMS. RDBMS is a different concept, but here pandas is basically you put the Excel table column wise. Whenever you put the Excel, whole table, you can put it, and you put the each column wise, and all columns should be of equal length. Definitely, it should be a rectangular one. Any data frame, it is called a data frame. In pandas, it is be rectangular, and this table, what is the limitation of size? Huge. It can be huge. it may be petabyte also. So it depends on the which Python platform. So that is the reason Python is very, it may be definitely megabyte, exabyte. So it is pandas, it depends on implementation. So, and most of the things we are generating tables. Right now, see, we are discussing our Google Meet, and Google Meet recording everything. So at what time we speak, everybody log in, log out, everything. Ultimately, they put in a table, and at what time you come in, and what time meeting started. So everything, basically, everywhere it is with table, whether your attendance, whether your marks, whether somebody joins to Facebook or comes out of the Facebook or anything, they everything is recorded on a table. This table you can manipulate with the Python. That is the strength of the Python. And the tables, the whole table, they call it as a data frame. Pandas call it as a data frame. And each columns, they call it a series. And columns should have equal length. And one good point is the column, certain data may be missing. In real life, that happens. So sometimes some data may not be there, network error and all this. So there is no issue about it. So the particular value, 9, that can be done. Let's see, we go through it. So the data, we basically know data. Data can be, say, data may be right now 3.25 p.m. Yeah, or 4.15 p.m. That is another data, 4.15. .337 second, that is a data. Your marks is a data, your other card number is a data, my other card, my ID. Data can be, so generally whenever we, in mathematics we know the data can be integer or positive integer or real number or rational number, irrational number like pi, all these things. A mathematics domain, like you know probably Z, imaginary number and all this, but in machine learning, imaginary number concept is not there. Here basically data is categorical data and numerical data. Numerical data like your height, weight and all these things where you have some numeric, and categorical data is basically like male, female or other gender or anything, yes, no, very good, all these things. This categorical data and two things. One is ordinal data. So ordinal data like your grade, like O, A, B, C, D, like O is always better than A, like this. And another is no relation between it, like male, female. How can I say male is better than female or male? So it is like a nominal data. So these kinds of data has to be handled in a, can be Python very easily, and the concept is there in these pandas. Let's see next screen. Same. So whatever I've discussed, same thing, like is a categorical data. Another data is actual where the number is real number or integer number is there. That is a previous concept I call it the numerical value. And now we concentrate on the categorical data. Categorical data is a nominal. So you cannot compare pen with pencil, male with female. It is a cow with dog, this is nominal. And ordinal, whenever like your grade, O, A, B, C, fantastic, okay, do not, you can, they always say, you can create a social media platform program. You can see the sentiment analysis program by Python. So getting the data from Twitter, Twitter comments, you can count which are the, which is better social site and which is getting more. So all these things you have to get the ordinal data. This pandas you can get it. The same thing I repeat. I got it. Sometimes some pictures gives more information, like quantitative, discrete, countable values. Like your marks, it is cannot be 22.2. It is can be always a extra. Your marks would be like 23, 24 of CA1 or CA2 or PCA1, PCA2. And continuous, like your weight and all, your height is continuous. So that is all these kinds of different data is handled. The same, another example of categorical data, I have already told gender, religion, method of treatment, type of teaching approach, marital status, qualification. These are basically categorical data, and these are the quantitative data. Categorical data, again, of two types, ordinal, so relation between these, and no relation. So all these things can be handled by this Python. We'll see it. Same thing, I got the screens from various sources. I think nothing new here. Yeah, this is a new thing. This is, I'm going to show you. I have already told you, this is a data frame. In a pandas, is a data frame. It consists of a NumPy. Remember, the basic Python, then NumPy. Pandas mainly works with NumPy. And these are the rows. But the row wise, it is not saved. They saved it in Python internally by this. This is series. We call it a series. This is the basic data. This data can be whatever I have told you, can be categorical data, nominal data, continuous data, discrete data, all data. And sometimes no data can be there. It is allowed. It is not that you have to have a data there. So this is called rows, and this is called the series, and whole thing is called as a Python as a data frame, and all this support is given by the pandas. You can see it more here. Yeah, it is what pandas versus NumPy. Pandas builds on NumPy arrays. I have told you series and data frame. Series, I must repeat, series means this is series. This is series, column wise the series, and columns should be of equal length. You can have only one column or more than hundreds columns, then you call a data frame. A series contains single set of common data with indices. Yeah, the series cannot have a numeric, sometimes it has a numeric, sometimes ordinal, sometimes cardinal. No, it's the same type of data. Like your RDBMS also, if you see an Excel table, in also same kinds of data. So that's it. So same kind of data. Data frame is a multiple series of same length. It should be at common row indices and columns the variables. Data frame represent data in tabular format. Yes, and columns are data frame need not be common data type. Yeah, it can be different. It is always. But within a column, you cannot change. So this is basic architecture, the Python, and then is a NumPy, and with the NumPy, Matplotlib, that is another class, previous class I've discussed. You can please see the videos. And Matplotlib is a graph, it's a view, how can you view this data, and pandas built on Matplotlib, NumPy, and so that you can visualize the data with, and your data source can be online data source. That is the great of the Python. We'll show it as an example. You can take data online from any table and view it, and you can manipulate it. So, and this is another package, MATLAB. And actually, last class I did, Matplotlib is a copied version of MATLAB, but it's open source, and this is huge costly software. Yes. So, this is Panda data structure, series index. Its index is there. I always must repeat, dictionary cannot have a 0-1 index. Dictionary always called by your key values. And here it's an index and series name and series values. What pandas can do? Pandas built a NumPy array with series and data frame. A series contains a single set of common data. I have told you a data frame is a multiple series. Yeah, so make it common rule. Data frame represents data in tabular format. And what is the use of pandas? Because machine learning, you need to feed, you have a lots of data that are available with labeled data. That means you have a lots of characteristics of a patient, say patient age, patient weight, height, weight, and age, and other medical details like blood pressure and all this. And then you have a tumor image, maybe a image of this tumor in image format, and whether the tumor class, whether it is a benign tumor or malignant tumor, just two classification. So you have a past student, if you have a radio imaging data, and you can have these images and age and all this, you can see already this data, tumor, the patient maybe died, that you know the history of this thing. If very unknown image comes, you can easily classify whether it can be a benign tumor or malignant tumor by learning from this without any help of radiologists, maybe not available at the current time, but later on a radiologist also can take help with the past data. That is the basic things of machine learning. Machine learning means right now a lot of data is being generated. We can feed the data with correct level, that whether this is a tumor type, cancerous or non-cancerous, and we generate a program becomes so intelligent after feeding the data, then you can take a undetected picture. It can tell almost 80 to 90% correctly that is correct prediction by expert. You know that machine learning, it can beat a chess player. All grandmasters can be beaten by a chess player in 100 out of 100, even the Go player. So in any particular area, machine is much more powerful than human. But what the machine cannot do multiple job at a time like human do. That is the strength, but we do not know. Maybe powerful machines can be available right now. They can do a lot of things. Okay, so that's a different scenario, but this is the Python strength. So let's go back to the this thing. Another thing I must tell you before go to the Python, I think you all know, I think I have, lambda function. This is also very interesting. In any Python interview question, this is asked, what is lambda function? Lambda function is inline function. It is a very beautiful way. So I just have a lambda function here. I don't have to say function name. So lambda function, the inline is one line. Here the lambda function name is, I wish to increase whatever I supply, I have to add 10 to it. So whenever I say x, this is a function name, and 5, then it will 10 plus 5, 15, and it is a 10 plus 6, 16. So this is a lambda function examples that it comes to my mind. Another lambda function, I come to pandas because just it come up. I think I should tell you, this is interesting questions might come up in your all Python. This is a lambda function. X, I declare it and the multiple argument here. So I supply two arguments, I get a product of it. So x equal to lambda is a keyword, and a comma b, the print x 5 comma 6, it will come up with 30 and 9 comma. You might ask why I use the lambda function, because it sometimes you need a handy function to be declared within that particular area. We don't have to use another big code. So is basically, if you see the visibility of the function within 10 or 15 lines, you can quickly make a lambda function. It should be one line and you can call it. So program length can be shorter and readability is better. Exactly. And you can put an X name, you can put it any, say I can use it product two numbers. So your readability also improves. That is this class of things I have discussed. I think I have discussed one day. Now I go to the pandas. Then I'll take questions from you. So here, this is the code from, it is the Google Colab from future. This is underscore underscore future, but you always will see underscore. like your underscore init. It is an internal variable of Python. This is particularly for Google Colab, and this is the pandas. Import pandas, like import numpy. So import pandas as a PD. You know that is a short form, so you can call it, and you always check it in your program. This is a PD underscore underscore version. This is a format string, and the format, and you can see the value, which panda value. So just let me run. It is coming. So I'll tell you wherever you can numpy, so that way you can check it, which version it is working. And that you are communicating with this. That is a great feature of Colab, that you can make incremental code and test it. So what I done it here, I just this is basically data frame and a series PD, because this PD is pandas PD and series, and this is a list. How do it's a list? A third bracket open 135 np.nan, but because I don't know the value, it's kind of a value like null, that just means zero. Basically it's undefined. Say in your C reference, I can call it whenever you malloc without calloc. Calloc is always return filled with zeros. When malloc anything, so np.nan is something like that, 6, 8, and you can see it earlier the integer. This is always the class type, always the pandas core series, and these are the values. So these are the values I'll give you. Okay. Float 64 it is giving. This will initialize. I just try once more. Here we another series. Here you see 1.0. You can make a like a list. You can put anything. Okay. And it will give anything. Like a list can contains. Like here, constructed data frame from a dictionary. You can from dictionary you can also take a data frame. Say same thing here. This is the index, it's a column one. This is a dictionary. How to say dictionary? Because the second column, this is the index, is a value. List can be there, list cannot be there. Here it is a string, so it is immutable. And you have created a data frame with this data. This is a dictionary, I would say T. And your data is D. So this is what is the type? It will say it. And this is the type. So this is a great way of panda. You can see D types. You can force a single data type by np integer. You can force it. Okay. Now interesting thing I wish to show. There are lots of things are there. I just want to show one interesting thing, then I'll come back. Yeah, here I can use a data frame. I can take online, and what is CSV, comma separated variables. Because there are some sites, huge data is available. California housing trend CSV, and I can run the data here, and data is coming up from internet, and the huge data. And not only that, it is calculating the. I can always the data. Not only that, I can describe. I can what does the what describe means within this data frame. How many count, mean, standard deviation, minimum, 25%, 50%, everything can be calculated. So that is the strength of Python. That is your data frame can be at remote place. It's a CSV. Online call it, you online analysis it, you can online visualize it with matplotlib. That is impossible through C, C++ or Java. That I can guarantee you. that is the strength of pandas. It not only the HTTPS protocol, it will, these data definitely should be available, and you can put it your data in your Google Drive or in your local drive. It can take the data, and not only that, it, every details you can intelligence about the data. Whenever huge data, for because you have to know certain association analysis, so which data goes to where, which two data common together, like a famous machine learning example is in US, it is found in Friday data. They found it, the people are buying the beer and the napkins, baby napkins together. So now the departmental stores, what they're doing, they found it suddenly Friday, they pick up in the sales in the napkin and the, because they, at the generally they do not stay in a Friday in USA. They, after Friday, they generally take a car and go something away, and Sunday morning or Sunday evening comes. So they always try to take some beer, and they always tip, they want to get rid of, so they want to say napkins for their children. So they buy this together. So what they do, this is called association analysis. They put the racks in Walmart, they put the racks together so they can buy together, and they might give arrangement, if you buy this, you can get it free. These are the typical characteristics they are using by retail market. You know this, now the Amazon and how they are ruling, Amazon and Walmart. So this kind of association analysis from the large data, from machine learning, they can discover. But generally, it cannot be discovered by your simple thing. But here, this Python machine learning, it can discuss. So just I have shown you this thing. Now go to the, just more once more, whatever we have done today. First of all, we have done to you today call by value. Mostly Python is a call by value, but call by reference is by list. List is immutable. So anything mutable, whenever you pass it, that is called by reference, but hardly anything is mutable in Python. I think it's the least is mutable. You have to check. Tuple is not mutable, that I can say. Set is mutable. Set you can say, because processor is not mutable. So you have to check. And most variables is not mutable. List is mutable. So you have to always think about it. And just quickly. So this is, I just repeat, so this codes will be given, the pandas as a PD and the version check, and now quickly, this I have shown it. You can, like here, construct a data frame from NumPy. Yes, it can be done. It's a NumPy array, it's the least one, and it is a, it, now it's a data frame. Data frame, and it cannot be in integer, floating point, anything. Here another example. See, this is kind of a data frame, and remember certain data can be missing. This is an index. This index, again I am telling repeatedly, dictionary cannot have index like 0, 1, 2, 3. Your list can have, dictionary can be only by the key values. So you always see the differences. Here it is, here is the index is there, so intentionally there. Now I open to question. Any, and the, all the problems have they are in GitHub, GitLab or Google Colab. So you think a problem which cannot be done, you see C, C++, Java, like machine learning, it can be machine learning, you can take it. Machine learning is a supervised machine learning with regression. I have told you what is supervised machine learning. Already supervised machine learning, nothing but you feed a lot of data and you know the result of this, yes, no, very good, and then you put an unknown data, you get what would be yes, no, like this. This is a classification, and if you want to be continuous output, say if you have a various ranges of flats at particular say area, say San Francisco, the data is there, the locality, the whether it is near to metro station there, and in which area, what is the center, then how many rooms are there, which floor it is. So you can expect a value. So that data is there, then you can put any other flat parameters you can, but that is a regression. So difference between regression is, regression output is a continuous one, and classification is, it is a bad tumor or malignant tumor or benign tumor. So that is classification. And whenever it is a supervised mode, we call it the classification, and when an unsupervised mode, that we call the clustering. We say, we feed the data, we say how many, two clusters, they automatically divide the data. That is the clustering. Difference between classification and clustering is, classification supervised, and supervision has a cost. You need a medical doctor or something supervised. Then after supervised, the machine, your program become intelligent. Then it take unknown data and it can say this is good, it's a benign tumor or malignant tumor. That is a supervised algorithm. Much easier. Okay. So try to get, there's lots of machine learning problems. Then you have to, NumPy will be used, Pandas will be used. Okay. And maybe Scikit, I'll cover in the next class. Because all these things, what I tell you, it is, don't have to go very detailed into it, because everything you have to revise again and again next 3 years. Even we are also revising. At least I am revising. So it, you just gloss through the papers and do some works in Python where you cannot do with Java C++. That is a Python advantage. You need to visualize the data. Any question, Shamodita, any question?